I am Guillaume Jobert with Siemens PLM Software. Today I will present you how to set up and calibrate a dual-core heat exchanger in LMS HAMSIM. Consider a typical air conditioning loop with various heat exchangers such as a condenser or an evaporator. What you want where you are using a modding software is that what you set in your software is exactly the real life. And in LMS HAMSIM, we have dedicated tools to ease this process. The first tool is about parameterizing, and you will see exactly the impact of your geometrical parameter. The second tool is used to calibrate your modeling, that is, the simulation results will be exactly the same as some experimental data that you have from a supplier. So in HAMSIM, consider this typical model, which you can have access to in the Get LMS HAMSIM demo, getting calibration here. This is a typical model for calibrating a dual core, which is a single component in the air conditioning library, dual core heat exchanger here. So this is a refrigerant air heat exchanger. The first thing you want to do is to parameterize it. Here you have a dedicated app that you can also launch by double clicking on it, and it will open this graphical window where you have your parameters and some graphical view to help visualize what you are setting. Here you have parameter for the external side, that means where the air flows through fins, and here this is parameter for the internal side, the refrigerant. For instance, consider you want to halve the fin pitch, that is the distance between fin. You can see that the drawing automatically adapts. The second thing is that there is some post-process values here, such as the hydraulic diameters or the fin length or so on. Second thing interesting with this tool is that perhaps you can change here the parameters, which seems correct, but there are some pre-processing in the application that shows that with the parameters you have set here, this is consistent mathematically with only one microchannel with these dimensions. And clearly, this doesn't fit with the tube 8. So here, the app clearly shows that there is some problem with your geometry. And here you can change and see that no, it seems correct. A second panel here shows you the heat exchanger globally. With the refrigerant pass. Here, this is very flexible. You can change, for instance, the pass at rear. Consider you have three pass and with different tubes for each pass. Here you see you have 10 tubes, 6 tubes, 10 tubes again. So you can set whatever architecture of your dual core you want, and very easily. So once your geometry is set, what you want is that your modeling is correct on the performance point of view. This is where the second tool comes in handy. This is a specific app that you can find here or just by double clicking on this component. In this app, you have experimental condition here and a match between simulation results and experimental one. The goal is to minimize two things, heat rejection and pressure drop at refrigerant side. This is done by modifying some parameters, which are the Nusselt correlation for the air flows and a pressure drop gain from the for the refrigerant side. It may happen that you already have a clue about some values that you can set. This is where you can use a single run here to run the simulation and to see whether they are good or not with respect to your experimental data. So we can see that okay, the results are not that bad, but we can improve that. This is when you can use the optimization process, which I can launch here. The optimization process relies on several simulations, and while it's running, I will present you some of the features. First is that the condition here, the boundary conditions, can be set with various things. For example, for the air condition, you can set either flow rate or velocity. For refrigerants, inlet condition, you can set temperature, separate subcooling, and here, considering an evaporator, obviously inlet gas mass fraction is the best setting. So there are several settings that can help you set your data with respect to supplier data very easily in this tool. And you can see that the optimization process is running and the total error is decreasing. So we are converging towards a good solution. Here, this is solution 5. Up to 10 simulations is normally okay to reach a good agreement between simulation results and experimental data. So here is the best values that match the experimental result you set. So once this is done, you can use your component here into a typical IC loop here, and you can use it for further analysis that are not presented in this video. So as a conclusion, you can see that in LMS AmSim, there are features that can help you ease the process of setting and calibrating an evaporator or actually any refrigerant air heat exchanger. Thank you for watching. For more information, please visit our website.